So let's start with another topic. And this topic is part of Indian performing arts. So classical. Classical dance forms of India. So under music, dance and drama and musical instruments. So whenever we use this word classical for any dance or music, what does this mean? Classical? Classical means based on rigid rules and regulations laid down for the past several centuries, and where deviation or improvisation is not at all allowed, while a performer or the artist is strictly adhered to the rules and regulations. So that's why it's called classical. While for regional or for folklore, folk dances, improvisation is easily allowed, could easily be improvised or compromised or altered, but here any classical dance form can never be altered. Rules and regulations are strictly followed, while deviations are always discouraged, and it takes a longer period of time to learn to have mastery over these dance, classical dance form. And according to an ancient classification, of dance forms, and the most important textbook of performing arts in our country, ancient India, is Natya Shastra. Shastra means literature, Natya means drama. A drama, a literature for drama. So Bharat Muni's Natya Shastra is the most important textbook for all the artists. So be it theater or dance forms or music. So ancient classification, it follows three different aspects of dance. First aspect of dance is called Natya. Then we have another aspect of dance form, and another aspect of dance called Nritya, and we have third one as well called Nrita. Natya, Nritya and Nrita. While Natya, as the word itself indicates, Natya means drama or dramatic element in the dance form. So Natya here means dramatic element, while nowadays least emphasis is given on Natya in a dance form. Least emphasis is given on Natya, this aspect of dance, present day, modern days, except for Kathakali, classical dance form of Kerala. So Kathakali is highly based on Natya, this aspect of dance. So while least emphasis is given on Natya, least emphasis is given on Natya except for Kathakali. While Nritya, which is in fact expressional. Nritya means expressional aspect of dance. And expressional, which means to convey any meaning to convey the meaning of a theme or idea. To convey the meaning of a theme or idea. So, like expressing any sahitya, for example, Shishupal Vadh, enslaying of Shishupal by Lord Krishna. So, Shishupal was the cousin of Lord Krishna, and finally, because of his atrocities, Shishupal was killed by Lord Krishna. So, like Shishupal Vadh, or some other themes from Ramayana or Mahabharata, like enslaying of Ravana by Rama or Hanumanji, any sahitya related to Hanumanji. So, it's actually expressional. Nritya is expressional. While third aspect of dance called Nrita. Nrita is a pure dance or abstract dance. Pure or abstract. Where body movement does not expresses any mood or emotion. Okay. So, according to an ancient classification of dance forms, we have three aspects of dance. First aspect is called Natya, second aspect is called Nritya, and third aspect is called Nrita. While Natya is the dramatic element in the dance form, and Nritya is the expressional, while Nrita is non-expressional. Doesn't convey any meaning or any mood or any emotion. While if a dancer, if an artist is going to express any sahitya or any theme or any emotion like anger, valor, love, disgust, he or she is free to use only two aspects. If you are going to express anything, you are going to adopt only two, that is Natya and Nritya. Nrita, being non-expressional, cannot be used by the artist to express any mood or emotion or ras or sahitya. It's completely non-expressional. Well, from next paragraph, only two aspects, that is Natya and Nritya, could be used by the dancers. To communicate Navras. Navras means nine emotions. Navras, such as wonder, joy, love, peace, compassion, valor, anger, fear, and disgust. Not necessary. Even I don't know the terms. Wonder. Kya bole wonder? Aashcharya. Wonder, joy, love, peace, compassion, valor, anger, fear, and disgust. So actually, this discussion is based on itself, based on CCRT. वहीं से मैटर लिया गया ये, ठीक है ना? CCRT, Center for Cultural Resources and Training, Ministry of Culture, Government of India official website. So, while we have three aspects of dance according to an ancient classification, and we have another classification as well. So, we have another classification describing various aspects of Natya. Aspects of Natya means first aspect of dance called Natya. Natya, Nritya, Nrita. So, we have aspects of Natya as well. And we have two aspects of Natya. First aspect is related to the modes of presentation. Modes of presentation, while another aspect of Natya is related to its style, or which is known as vritti. Style or vritti. So, modes of presentation, it includes two different modes of presentation: formalized presentation and informal presentation. So, formalized presentation is called Natya Dharmi. Formalized presentation is known as Natya Dharmi. Natya Dharmi or formalized presentation. And we have another mode of presentation of Natya called Lok Dharmi. Lok Dharmi, which means regional. Lok Dharmi or regional or informal. So we have formalized mode of presentation of Natya and regional presentation of Natya. And when it comes to the style or vritti of Natya aspect of dance, it includes four different styles. First one is called Kashiki. First vritti or first style of Natya is called Kashiki. Kashiki means lyrical. Kashiki or lyrical. Then there is another vritti called Arbati. Arbati, which means energetic and masculine. Arbati, which means energetic, highly energetic and masculine. Then we have third style called Satvati. Satvati, or which depict emotions, which depict emotions. And fourth one, which is known as fourth style, is called Bharati. Bharati, or Bharati here means literature, like Ramayana, Mahabharata, Geet Govind, Bhagavad Gita, Shishupal Vadh, ye sab aate hain usme. Bharati, or which means literary content. Literary content. So, there are two aspects of Natya. First aspect is related to mode of presentation, and we have two modes of presentation, formalized and informal. Natya Dharmi and Lok Dharmi. And there are four styles related to natya aspect of dance. And first aspect is called Kashiki, which is lyrical, very lyrical. Second style is actually energetic and masculine, called Arbati. Then we have third style called Satvati, which is generally used to depict 9 different emotions, while we have Bharati, or our literary content. And apart from this classification of dance forms called Natya, Nritya and Nrita, we have another classification as well. So next one, and ancient classification which is followed in almost all types of dance forms . First one is known as Tando, and this particular dance form called Tando is related to Lord Shiva, the god of destructive forces, destructive potential. So the Tando, which is related to Lord Shiva and is related to destructive forces, and that's why Tando is highly energetic dance form. It takes lot of energy to perform Tando dance form. Bahut vigorous hota hai, bahut zabardast, isme bahut puri energy laga ke dance karna padega. So it's highly energetic and it's masculine as well. It's heroic, masculine, vigorous, energetic. So Tando in masculine means male steps predominates, masculine. Then heroic, bold and vigorous. And another aspect is called Abhinay. Abhinay means dramatic element, Abhinay, or dramatic element. And third one, which is called Lasya. While Tando is masculine form and Lasya is feminine, and female steps predominates here in the distance form, the aspect of dance called Lasya. So Lasya is feminine and being feminine, it's soft, it's lyrical and it's graceful, dignified, it's graceful dance form. And according to this classification, Abhinay or dramatic element, it can be achieved through 4 different ways. Abhinay can be achieved through, this can be achieved through Angika, can be achieved, Abhinay can be achieved through Angika. Angika means through the movement of body parts and limbs. Angika through the body and limbs. So body movement or movement of parts of body, it differs from dance to dance. Like in case of Kathakali, there is the great role of minor body parts. Minor body parts like fingers, wrist, eyebrow, eyeball, lower lid. While in case of Odissi, three movements are very important: neck, shoulder, and torso. Torso, not shoulder. Neck, knee, and torso. While in case of Kathak, full foot control is very important. Pair bilkul seedhe aise padta hai, flat aise padega. While in case of Kathakali, weight of the body is not equally distributed. Weight of the body is on outer edges of the feet, which is slightly bent. So it depends. It varies from one dance to another one, called Angika. And through the body and Angika can be achieved through the movement of body parts and limbs. So we have another one. Dramatic element can be achieved through Vachika. Vachika, bolna, which means songs and speech. And third, which is called Aharya. Aharya, which means costume and adornment, jewelry, costume and jewelry. While you could easily identify a Kathakali performer, in case of Kathakali, paint is applied on the face. Green paint depicts heroic character like Lord Rama, Lakshman, Lord Shiva, Lord Krishna, Jagannath. When there is the combination of red and green, that indicates anti-heroes, but anti-heroes were so brave, they were the warriors and they were learned people like Raman. Raman was considered to be a great warrior. And forest dwellers like Eklavya, forest dweller. So Kathakali mein Eklavya ke chehre pe black paint hoega. To ye pata chal jata hai. Like in case of Mohiniyattam, white or off-white cloths are used by the performer or the dancer. So Aharya, which means costume and adornment. And the fourth one, which is called Angika, Vachika, Ahare, and Satvika. Satvika here means moods and emotions. Moods and emotions. Okay. So these are the basics or fundamentals of dance forms and classification, in fact. Now start with Bharatanatyam. Bharatanatyam, this classical dance form, it's based on Natya Shastra. Almost all the important dance forms are based on Bharat Muni's Natya Shastra. So based on Natya Shastra of Bharat Muni and Abhinay Darpan of Nandikeshwar. Abhinay Darpan, textbook of Nandikeshwar. While Bharatnatyam itself is based on, steps are based on Natya Shastra of Bharat Muni and Abhinay Darpan of Nandikeshwara. And this dance itself is based on, it includes grace, it includes purity, tenderness, expressions, and also famous for sculptural poses. Famous for sculptural poses. Grace, purity, tenderness, expression, and sculptural poses. And it includes bhav, bhavam, ragas, ragam, rhythm called talam, and dramatic element called natyam. So based on Bharatnatyam, which is based on bhavam, ragam, talam, and natyam. While Bharatnatyam, it is considered to be fire dance. It's considered to be fire dance. Fire dance here means not including any kind of firework. So fire dance means expressing metaphysical element of fire of our own body. बोलते ना कि हमारा शरीर कितने तत्वों से बना हुआ है? पांच तत्वों से बना हुआ है, पंच तत्व. और जलने के बाद किसमें विलीन हो जाएगा? पंच तत्वों में विलीन हो जाएगा. तो उसमें एक तत्व आग है ना, अग्नि, फायर. सो इट इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी फायर डांस, विच मींस एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ मेटाफिजिकल एलिमेंट ऑफ fire in human body. Expression of metaphysical element of fire in human body. While Bharatnatyam is essentially ek harya dance, considered to be ekharya dance form. Ekharya means solo. So usually not performed in groups. Usually not performed in groups. So ekharya means single, one dancer takes on many roles in single performance. One dancer takes on many roles in single performance. So one dancer takes on many roles in single performance, which means Bharatnatyam dancer, she is going to perform masculine and feminine as well. So it includes lasse and tando. Like your tando girl. काट लेगा तो हालत खराब हो जाएगी. इसको मारिए कॉपी से. इतना कहां से आ गया अंदर. लास्ट से फेमिनाइन और फेमिनिन, वाइल तांडो मैस्कुलिन. So which means many split characters are performed by one dancer, usually female. A female dancer is put there. So a female Bharatnatyam dancer, she is going to play lasse as well as tando, which means many split characters. Many split characters performed by one dancer. And we have several patterns of Bharatnatyam. Steps, patterns means steps of Bharatnatyam. So at next heading, patterns of Bharatnatyam. And altogether, we have five different patterns or stages of Bharatnatyam. First stage, first pattern or first stage is called Alarippu. First stage is called Alarippu. Which means to adorn with flowers. हाँ वो काट लेगा तो किसी को बुलाइए. तो जाएगा भी नहीं, बड़ा मुश्किल है. वीडियो बनाएगा. देखिए बुलाई जरा किसी को. जी 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 हत्या हो गया ना. महावीर स्वामी कितने दुखी होंगे. अलरिप्पु और टू अडॉर्न विथ फ्लावर्स. सो जस्ट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ भरतनाट्यम डांस. फर्स्ट स्टेज इज कॉल्ड अलरिप्पु, लिटरली मीनिंग टू अडॉर्न विथ फ्लावर्स. ठीक है ना. सो एंड इट कंबाइनिंग dance and recitation of sound syllables. It combines dance and recitation of sound syllables. Recitation of sound syllables here means pronunciation of a phrase from any sahitya. So Alarippu is the beginning, first stage. Alarippu is followed by second stage, which is called Jatishwaram. Well, Alarippu is nothing. Alarippu is the beginning, entry of the dancer on this stage, and invocation of the deity. School days में देखते हैं ना, हम लोगों ने play अगर आपने किया होगा तो सबसे पहले क्या करते हैं? सरस्वती वंदना या भगवान की पूजा, भगवान को फूल चढ़ाना, यही करते हैं ना. तो ये वही स्टेज होता है. Alarippu is like invocation of the deity. It's like offering flowers. And dance itself begins from the second stage called Jatishwaram. Why this second stage of second stage called Jatishwaram of Bharatanatyam is based on this aspect called Nrita, pure dance or abstract dance. Why pure dance or abstract dance doesn't convey any meaning or any mood or any emotion or any sahitya or literature. So Jatishwaram is abstract or pure dance with musical notes of Carnatic music. Musical notes of Carnatic classical music of South India. So Alarippu followed by Jatishwaram, and Jatishwaram is the pure dance or abstract dance, which is followed by Shabdam. So Shabdam, इसी से पता चल रहा है. Shabda means a dancer is going to express any sahitya. So Shabda means when dancer expresses sahitya through the movement. Expressing sahitya through the movement. And Shabdam is followed by the most difficult stage of this dance form. Fourth one, which is called Varnam. Varnam. And Varnam is the most important composition. This is the most important composition and it includes simultaneously Nritya and Nrita, which means expressional and non-expressional together. And this is the most difficult part of this dance form, Bharatanatyam. And for this reason, it takes a longer period of time to command these steps, to have command over the steps. Bahut difficult hai ye. 20-25 saal lag jate hain Bharatanatyam seekhne mein. Theek hai na? So, because of this stage, Varnam, and it includes Nritya, which is expressional, and Nrita, abstract or pure or non-expressional. Well, last step or last stage of this Bharatanatyam dance form is called Tillana. So Tilana, well, tilana is nothing. Tilana, in this stage, meaningless words are pronounced in a rhythmic manner. तो समझ जाते कि अब जाने का टाइम आ गया है, ठीक है ना? So tilana, right here, meaningless, meaningless words in rhythmic way or rhythmic manner. Meaningless words in rhythmic manner. So there are five stages. Savita Shastri, one of the great exponent of this dance form. So performing Bharatanatyam. So metaphysical expression of metaphysical element of fire in our body. इतना ही पढ़ा सकता हूं इसमें, इससे ज्यादा मेरे बाप दादाओं ने भी कभी डांस नहीं किया होगा. सो आई हैव स्टडीड हिस्ट्री एंड नॉट डांस एंड ड्रामा एंड म्यूजिक, बट दिस स्टेज इज द फर्स्ट वन कॉल्ड अलरिप्पू. टू अराउंड विथ, कैसे है ना, हाथ ऐसे लगा हो ना, ऐसे फ्लावर सेट से डालते ना, अलरिप्पू. First stage Alarippu, followed by Jatishwaram, then Shabda. See, Alarippu, to down with flowers, invocation of the deity. Then next stage is Jatishwaram. Jatishwaram is the abstract dance. Jatishwaram is the abstract dance. So while performing Jatishwaram, it's not possible to interpret that part or that stage of dance form. इसमें interpretation नहीं होगा कुछ, कुछ आप meaning नहीं निकाल पाएंगे. Abstract dance है. So accompanied with Carnatic music. लेकिन music तो आ ही नहीं रहा. It's non-expressional. म्यूजिक जिम से आ रहा. म्यूजिक उसे आएगा कुछ नहीं आएगा, नहीं आएगा भाई. जटेश्वरम इज फॉलोड बाय शब्दम. यहां पे किसके लिए बोल रहे हैं? भगवान कृष्णा प्लेइंग फ्लूट. तो जहां पे आप इंटरप्रेट कर ले जाएंगे ना, वहां पे इंटरप्रिटेशन अपने आप आपको समझ में आएगा कि क्या हो रहा है. एक्सप्रेशन, सो एक्सप्रेसिंग, सो शब्दम, शब्द मीन्स एक्सप्रेसिंग एनी साहित्य. सो परहैप्स फ्रॉम गीत गोविंद ऑफ जयदेव. म्यूजिक होता तो ज्यादा ही अच्छा लगता है ना. पीछे जो बोल रही ना, ये कह रहे हैं कि नयनम मधुरम कटिकम मधुरम, ऐसे पीछे बोल रहा है वो. भूल गया हूं सब, पहले याद था. नयनम मधुरम मतलब आंखें बहुत खूबसूरत हैं, सुंदर है.
लिप्स बोल रहे हैं बड़े ब्यूटीफुल है, ऐसा वो कह रहे हैं। चलिए क्या हो गया, ये हैंग कर जाता है हमेशा। नेक्स्ट वन, फेमस डांसर्स। फर्स्ट वन सविता शास्त्री, फेमस डांसर्स और ग्रेट एक्सपोनेंट्स सविता शास्त्री। सेकेंड वन रामा वैद्यनाथन। एंड थर्ड वन सरगुजा टैगोर। रामा वैद्यनाथन सरगुजा टैगोर। कथकली परफॉर्मेंस अभी ऐड आए ना। क्या एंड भी हो गया, ये कैसे हो सकता है, क्या हो गया? कथकली डांस फॉर्म इज हाईली स्टाइलाइज्ड डांस फॉर्म, व्हाइल एम्फेसिस इज ऑन द मूवमेंट ऑफ माइनर बॉडी पार्ट्स लाइक आईब्रो, आईलिड एंड स्पेशली आईबॉल, मूवमेंट ऑफ आईबॉल। एंड इट इंक्लूड्स ऑल द थ्री एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ डांस, नाट्य, नृत्य एंड नृता, से मूवमेंट ऑफ माइनर बॉडी पार्ट्स, से आईबॉल, आईलिड, फिंगर्स, रिस्ट, क्या कह रहे हैं वो मुझे भी नहीं पता। कार्नाटिक प्लेइंग, कार्नाटिक म्यूजिक, ब्रास है ना, ब्रास। चलिए हो गया, चलिए पेंडिंग। सेट नेक्स्ट वन, कथा मीन्स स्टोरी, कथकली। भरतनाट्यम तमिलनाडु, कथकली केरला, क्लासिकल डांस फॉर्म ऑफ केरला। सो केरला कथकली एज अ डांस पॉपुलर टुडे is considered to be comparatively recent origin. However,
It is an art which has evolved from many social and religious theatrical forms, theatrical forms. So underline this part, it's very important, which has evolved from many social and religious theatrical forms. Which existed in the southern region in ancient times, which existed in the southern region in ancient times. So it's said to be comparatively of recent origin, but based on several other theatrical forms of southern India or South India, such as smagli kega, just kon kon se theatrical forms of South India. Chakyar kutu. Kudiyattam. You put your prelims, man. Kudiyattam. Krishnattam and Ramanattam. Are few of the ritual performing arts of Kerala, which have had a direct influence of Kathakali. Direct influence on Kathakali in its form and technique. Direct influence of on Kathakali in its form and technique. Okay. So of recent origin and evolved out of various theatrical forms of southern ancient India, such as Chakyar Kutu, Kudiyattam, Krishnattam and Ramanattam. These are few of the ritual performing arts of Kerala, which have had a direct influence on Kathakali in its present form and technique. And it also includes martial art tradition of Kerala. Martial art tradition of Kerala. Kya bolte hain? Kalari Payattu. Okay. It also includes. Yeah, usi mein dhoond lenge. Yes, ko rehne dete hain. Martial art tradition of Kerala. Kalari Payattu. Exactly pronounced Kalari Payattu. It's very, very difficult. The
the origin of all martial arts. कहाँ चला गया सर? It's very difficult to learn martial art tradition of Kerala. ये क्या है? थोड़े समझ गए ना? Right from next paragraph, add one more paragraph. मैं भी लिखा रहा हूं उसको. In the temple sculptures in Kerala, and the frescoes means mural painting, including two different techniques of mural painting called frescoes and tempera. So in the temple sculptures in Kerala and the frescoes in the Mattancherry temple of the 16th century common era, dance scene depicting the square, and rectangular positions, so typical to Kathakali, are seen. So square and rectangular body position for body movement, and choreographical pattern, Kathakali is also indebted to the early martial art of Kerala called Kalaripattu. ये भी पूछा IAS prelims. Kalaripattu. Next paragraph. Kathakali is a blend of, from next paragraph. Kathakali is a blend of dance, music, and drama. Kathakali is a blend of dance, music, and drama, and dramatizes stories which are mostly adopted from Indian epics,
mostly adopted from Indian epics. So while Kathakali borrows Sahitya from so many sources, including Ramayana and Mahabharata, but Bharatanatyam, it takes Sahitya only from two epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata, while Kathakali includes large number of Sahitya or literary sources. While Bharatanatyam, it is almost completely based on Ramayana and Mahabharata. Wahan pe Sahitya limited, Ramayana and Mahabharata. While Kathakali includes a wide range of Sahitya. Right, further. It is a stylized art form. Comma. The four aspect of Abhinay. Stylized art form. Comma lagai. The four aspect of Abhinay. The four aspect of Abhinay. Dash. Put a dash mark. And what are four aspects of Abhinay? Yes. Angika, Vachika, Aharya and Satvika. See here. It includes all the four aspects called Angika, Vachika, Aharya and Satvika. Angika means expression through the body and limbs. Vachika, songs and speech. Aharya, typical costume and adornment, jewelry. And Satvika, different moods or emotions. Okay. So Angika, Vachika, Aharya and Satvika, and Natya, Nritya and Nrita. And Natya, Nritya and Nrita. Aspects are combined perfectly. Natya, Nritya and Nrita aspects are combined perfectly. The dancer expresses himself or herself. The dancer expresses himself through codified hast mudras. Codified hast mudras. HAST. Hast MUDRAS. Hast mudras means movement of limbs. Fingers, wrist. And codified hast mudras and facial expressions. Next point or next paragraph. Kathakali dance is chiefly interpretative. Kathakali dance is chiefly interpretative. Interpret karna hoga aapko dekh karke. The characters in a Kathakali are broadly divided into Sattvika, Rajasika and tamasika. Sexually, sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. Sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. Sattvic, like heroes, Lord Rama, Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, having sattvic element, pavitra, sacred. While rajasic means a blend of sattvic and tamasic. Tamasic means gray shade, है ना, anti-hero. Tamasic का मतलब क्या होता है? बुरे लोग. और सात्विक मतलब पवित्र, pious. और राजसिका का मतलब दोनों का blend हो, जो थोड़ा warrior भी हो, विद्वान भी हो, लेकिन वो थोड़ा सा wicked भी हो, थोड़ा सा दुष्ट भी हो, दोनों का blending हो. तो सात्विका, राजसिका and तामसिका types. In, from next paragraph, in Pacha, it's a pattern of paint applied on the face. In Pacha, comma, green color predominates and kirit, वो जो सर के ऊपर मुकुट पहना ना, headgear, kirit is worn by all and Krishna and Rama wore special crowns decorated with peacock. So, Pacha, it depicts heroes, Rama and Krishna. Next one, the kathi, pacha, and we have another one called kathi. So the kathi type depicts anti-heroes, villains. Kathi type depicts anti-heroes of Kathi type depicts anti-heroes of Rajasika category. Rajasika category. They are sometime great warriors and scholars. Kathi, so it's a blend of anti-heroes, blend of Sattvika, Rajasika and Tamasika. So while Sattvika, pious characters, Rajasika, blend of pious and gray shade. So isme color ka bhi blending hoga, red and green. So while red and green colors are applied on the face of a character, means depicting any particular Rajasika character, like Raman, Kans, Shakuni, Shishupal, Bolo, scholars, warriors and scholars, such as Duryodhan, a great warrior. Duryodhan himself was a great warrior, lekin acha bhi hai aur bura bhi hai. Raman, Kans and Shishupal. So Pacha, then we have Kathi. Next one, the characters of thadi category. It's a bit technical, you know, dance forms. Thoda sa technical hai. Thadi means dadhi, beard. मलयालम में ना केरला में लैंग्वेज मलयालम है तो मलयाली में थाड़ी दाढ़ी. सो द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ थाड़ी कैटेगरी इंक्लूड्स थ्री. चुव्वना थाड़ी, वेल्ला थाड़ी. मजेदार है ना, कभी कभी तो हम लोग साउथ इंडिया पढ़ते ही थोड़ा थोड़ा. चुवना थाड़ी, वेल्ला थाड़ी, करुत्ता थाड़ी. चुवना थाड़ी मीन्स रेड बियर्ड. वेल्ला थाड़ी व्हाइट बियर्डेड कैरेक्टर्स. जैसे हनुमान जी को जब भी स्टेज पे दिखाएंगे ना तो सफेद दाढ़ी वाला ऐसा लगा के दिखाएंगे और वो मंकी वाले कॉस्ट्यूम में होंगे, होगा कैरेक्टर जो डांसर होगा. और करुत्ता थाड़ी मीन्स ब्लैक बियर्ड. कितने हो गया, तीन हो गया ना. पाचा, क्या डिस्कशन हुआ ने, पाछा, देन काठी एंड थाडी एंड राइट फोर्थ वन कारी आर कैरेक्टर्स. कारी आर कैरेक्टर्स whose makeup have a kari means black, kala, whose makeup have a black base. They wear black costume depicting a hunter or forest dweller. जैसे ये महाभारत में एक कैरेक्टर है ना एकलव्य, तो एकलव्य वॉज अ फॉरेस्ट ड्वेलर निशाल एंड ही बिलोंग टू अ हंटर कम्युनिटी. सो व्हाइल ही हिमसेल्फ वॉज अ वेरी गुड आर्चर एंड ही वॉन्टेड टू बी द बेस्ट. So one day he had approached Guru Dronacharya, who was appointed to train, to impart knowledge of archery, knowledge of operating sword and mace to the Pandava and Kaurava Rajkumars or princes. So while he had approached Guru Dronacharya, Guru Dronacharya refused to impart knowledge of archery because he belonged to a lower community, Shudra. And Shudras during the later Vedic period were not entitled to have education. Even they were not entitled to wear sacred thread called janeu. तो अगर एकलव्य को वो पूरा प्ले कर रहे होंगे डांसर्स, तो एकलव्य को जब दिखाया जाएगा तो चेहरे पे ब्लैक मेकअप होगा, तो वो पता चल जाएगा कि ब्लैक वाला जो वो कैरेक्टर है वो इंटरप्रेट करना होता है, इस इंटरप्रिटेटिव डांस फॉर्म. सो हंटर और फॉरेस्ट ट्रेलर. Alright, next one. In no other dance style is the entire body used so completely in Kathakali. In no other dance style is the entire body used so completely as in Kathakali. The technical details, cover every part of body. The technical detail cover every part of the body from facial muscles to fingers, eyes, hands and wrists. The facial muscle play an important part. The movement of the eyebrows, the eyeballs and lower eyelids are not used to such an extent in any other dance style Full stop. Right, further. The weight of the body is on outer edges of the feet. Which are slightly bent and curved. See, so movement of eyeball, eyebrows, eyelids and lips. वो म्यूजिक के साथ चल रहा है आईबॉल का मूवमेंट. जैसे जैसे म्यूजिक तेज होगा आईबॉल भी मूवमेंट भी तेज होगा. हाईली डिफिकल्ट टू कमांड ओवर माइनर बॉडी पार्ट्स. फेशियल मसल्स. Kathakali, Duryodhan Vadham. So depicting Duryodhan Vadham. Interpret karna hota hai, isme musibat yahi hoti hai. देखिए नाक पे गोल गोल लगा हुआ है सफेद सफेद, और एक यहां पे इसको बोलते हैं छुट्टी पो, छोटी है ना छोटी छुट्टी पो। आई डोंट नो दैट, इतना ही बहुत है पढ़ना। इधर बैठ, दुर्योधन वध में हनुमान जी कहां होंगे? कहां का कहां ले जा रहे हैं? दुर्योधन वध तो महाभारत में, हनुमान जी तो रामायण में। नाराज हो जाएंगे प्रभु हनुमान, छोड़िए। चले लिखे राइट नेक्स्ट वन, स्टेजेस ऑफ कथकली। स्टेजेस ऑफ कथकली, फर्स्ट स्टेज इज कॉल्ड तोडायम, तोडायम, तोडायम इज एक्चुअली डिवोशनल नंबर। इन्वोकेशन ऑफ द डीआईटी ना, अलरिप्पु जो भरतनाट उसमें था ना, अलरिप्पु, तो यहां पे तोडायम बोलते हैं। तोडायम डिवोशनल नंबर is performed with one or two characters to invoke the blessing of the god, to invoke the blessings of the god. Todayam, todayam is followed by केलिकोटू, केलिकोटू मतलब फॉर्मल अनाउंसमेंट। फॉर्मल अनाउंसमेंट ऑफ द परफॉर्मेंस, एंड ड्रम्स एंड सिंबल्स, सिंबल्स समझते हैं वो डफली, ऋषि कपूर, ऋषि कपूर हमेशा जो गाने में बजाते थे वो सिंबल है, CYMBL सिंबल, डफली तबला, फॉर्मल अनाउंसमेंट ऑफ द परफॉर्मेंस ड्रम डन एंड ड्रम्स एंड सिंबल्स आर प्लेड फॉर अ वाइल। दिल पे ले लिए तो ड्रम्स, ड्रम्स एंड सिंबल्स, थर्ड वन पुरप्पाडू, पुरप्पाडू एंड पुरप्पाडू इज अ प्योर नृता डांस। प्योर नृता डांस मीन्स नॉन एक्सप्रेशनल, इट इज फॉलोड बाय ये याद रखना पड़ेगा आप लोगों को, मिलप्पाडा, म्यूजिशियंस एंड ड्रमर्स hold this stage, musicians and drummers hold this stage entertaining the audience, theek hai na, while the the most important part of Kathakali is Tiranokku. Debut on the stage, entry of the characters on the stage, a debut of this on the stage of all characters. Thereafter, play or the particular scene of the chosen play begins.
यहां से शुरुआत हो रही है लास्ट स्टेज में है ना. सो तिरनोक्कू ये एक्सप्रेसिंग साहित्य, एक्सप्रेसिंग एनी पर्टिकुलर ड्रामा साहित्य और एनी माइथोलॉजिकल स्टोरी और एनी माइथोलॉजिकल इवेंट. तो यहां से जैसे दुर्योधन वध है तो कहां से शुरू होगा, यहां से शुरू ही होगा दुर्योधन वधम. फिर सब लोग इकट्ठे आएंगे, युधिष्ठिर, अर्जुन, भीम, भीष्म पितामह, द्रोणाचार्य, सब पता नहीं कहेंगे जो भी कैरेक्टर्स हैं, ठीक है ना. तो कितने फाइव स्टेजेस हो गए ना. फर्स्ट स्टेज It's called Todayam. Todayam is devotional number followed by Kelikottu. While Kelikottu is the formal announcement of the performance, third part Purappadu is a Nrita dance. While Purappadu is followed by Milappada, which means entertaining the audience, while finally play begins. So it's called Tiranokku, debut on the stage of all the characters. Thereafter, play on the of the particular scene of the chosen play begins. Okay, so Bharatanatyam from Tamil Nadu, Kathakali from Kerala, and next one, third one, Kathak. Kathak, which is derived from saying katha. Kathak, Uttar Pradesh. And Kathak, it includes music, dance, and narratives. Music, dance, and narratives. So, well, Kathak means saying katha, कि जैसे अब मान लीजिए आप लोग बैठे हैं, गांव वाले हैं, मैं कथा बोल रहा हूं है ना, ऐसी कोई कथा कह रहे हैं कि लक्ष्मण मूर्छित पड़े हुए हैं और उनको जड़ी बूटी चाहिए. तो फिर पता चलता है कि हम हिमालय पे कहीं संजीवनी बूटी है. तो कैसे संजीवनी बूटी आए, तो किसी को समझ में नहीं आता. हनुमान जी बोलते हैं मैं लाता हूं, वो जाते हैं और पूरा पहाड़ी उखाड़ लाते हैं. तो उसपे से फिर जो वैद्य होते हैं वो संजीवनी बूटी निकाल लेते हैं. तो ये तो सिर्फ कथा हुआ, मजा नहीं आया है ना. अगर उसमें एक्ट किया जाए, लाइक हनुमान जी वेंट ऑल द वे टुवर्ड्स द हिमालय एंड देन ही ब्रिंग अलोंग विद हिमसेल्फ दैट माउंटेन, और वो सब पूरा प्ले करके जब बताया जाएगा तो उसी को फिर जेस्चर्स बोलेंगे ना. सो कथक, इट वॉज बेस्ड ऑन ओरल ट्रेडिशन ऑफ सेइंग कथा ड्यूरिंग द मिडिल एजेस, व्हाइल स्टेप्स और जेस्चर्स पोस्चर्स वर एडेड लेटर ऑन ड्यूरिंग द सबसीक्वेंट एजेस टू मेक रिसाइटेशन मोर मीनिंगफुल एंड मोर इफेक्टिव. And around 15th century common era, there was the emergence of Ras Leela in the Braj region, Mathura, Agra, and adjacent areas. And that
played a very important role in the development of Kathak. While like Mirabai, Nandadas, Surdas, Devdas, saints, devotees of Lord Krishna. तो इन लोगों ने काफी contribution किया. But Kathak as a dance form took place at the court of the Mughals. Or in fact, later Mughal rulers. And also at the court of Nawabs of Awadh. वहां से ये एक डांस फॉर्म में आया. उसी को उसको क्या बोलते हैं, कथक डांस फॉर्म. सो राइट, फर्स्ट पॉइंट, कथक विच इज बेस्ड ऑन ओरल ट्रेडिशन ऑफ सेइंग कथा और recitation from epics, myths and legends. Oral tradition of saying katha or recitation from epics, myths and legends. Second point, gestures were added later on to make recitation more effective. Third point, it was mainly centered around Radha Krishna theme and Vaishnavite cult of 15th century. Mainly centered on Radha Krishna theme and Vaishnavite cult of 15th century contributed a whole new range of lyrics and musical form. So Kathak started taking shape as a dance form only during the 15th century common era and onwards. When Kathak was mainly patronized by the later Mughal rulers during the 18th centuries and the Nawabs of 17th and 18th centuries and the Nawabs of Awadh. So then only this emerged as a proper dance form. So including lyrics and musical form. Next point. Emergence of Ras Leela in the Braj region, was an important development. Was an important development. And the later Mughal rulers and later Mughal rulers and Nawabs of Awadh contributed a lot in this sphere. See, one of the greatest exponent of Kathak dance form, Pandit Birju Maharaj from Banaras, Banaras Gharana. See, if you observe this dance form, weight of the body is always equally distributed along the vertical and horizontal axis. Iska matlab hai jo body ke curves hain, bends hain, unka istemal नहीं होता है. See, weight of the body is always distributed along the horizontal and vertical axis, while full foot control is very important. मतलब पैर बिल्कुल सपाट पड़ेगा, कर्व नहीं लेगा थोड़ा भी, ठीक है ना. See, there is no deflection of curves or bends of the body. And there is another technical detail called spinning or twirling, T-W-I-R-L, twirling, 360 degree movement. Beech beech mein dekhiyega, pura ghum jayenge. Ye Kathak ki pehchan. Or ankle. घुंघरुओं की आवाज पे पूरा कंट्रोल होगा. जिसका इंटरेस्ट होता है उनको बहुत मजा आता है. लोग हजारों रुपए खर्च करके टिकट लेके जाते हैं पंडित बिरजू महाराज को देखने. लाइक नेक्स्ट एडिंग characteristics of Kathak. Characteristics of Kathak. First one, weight of the body is equally distributed along the horizontal and vertical axis. Along the horizontal and vertical axis. Second point, full foot control is of prime importance. Full foot control is of prime importance. Third one, no deflection and no use of sharp bends or curves. No deflection or no use of sharp bends or curves. Fourth one, Nrita, N-R-I-T-T-A. Nrita or pure dance is all important Nrita or pure dance is all important. And effects are created through the use of flat feet and control of sound of ankle bells, ghungru, and control of sound of ankle bells worn by the dancers, WORN, worn by the dancers. Next one. The dance commences with a soft gliding movement, of the neck, eyebrows and the wrists. And last one. Spinning or twirling, T-W-I-R-L. Spinning or twirling is the most important aspect of this dance. So, Kathak from Uttar Pradesh. Next one. Odissi, classical dance form of Odisha. So while Odissi is a religious kind of dance, while we were discussing about the temple architecture, and under the Nagara style of temple architecture, we have discussed three regional variations. So temples of Central India, temples of Western India, and temples of Eastern India, including the temples of Odisha, then Assam and Bengal. While in the temples of Odisha, to unka jo basic plan tha, bilkul waise hi tha. And Odisha temples are the best example of Rekha Prasad type of temple. So having curvilinear, shikhar and circular amlak. Square base called sanctorum or Garbha Griha. But in the Odisha temples, Garbha Griha is called Deul. And supporting structures like Mandap and Ardha Mandap called Natya Mandir and Bhog Mandir, assembly halls called Natya Mandir and Bhog Mandir. Natya Mandir here means dancing hall, and Bhog Mandir means dining hall, to feed the deity, to entertain the deity and to feed the deity. While in this Natya Mandir of Odisha temple, there emerged a dance form which is nowadays known as Odissi classical dance form. So it's mainly a religious dance form originated from the temples of Odisha. Okay, so it's a religious kind of dance. Originated from the temples of Odisha, mainly dedicated to Radha, Krishna and Radha Krishna cult and Jagannath philosophy. So, well, at the Nat Mandir, female dancers were appointed, called, so female here, female dancers, called Mehri. वो आप लोग जानते हैं ना देवदासी tradition. यही से ना देवदासी traditions. So Mehri from देवदासी tradition. Female dancers. They were originally temple. Mehri, they were temple dancers. So while later on, so in the beginning, in the temples, dance was performed by Mehris or Devadasis. And later on, Devadasis were also appointed at the court of the kings. And from there and onwards, this dance form started degrading or declining. Then a group of boys was prepared to further carry forward pure aspects or pure steps of this dance form. कुछ लड़कों को सेलेक्ट किया गया, उनको सिखाया गया कि आप लोग मंदिर में जाके डांस करो. सो ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम थ्री डिफरेंट स्टाइल्स ओरिजिनेटेड अंडर दिस डांस फॉर्म. फर्स्ट स्टाइल डेवलप्ड एट इनटू द टेंपल्स, इनटू द नट मंदिर कॉल्ड मेहरी ट्रेडिशन. अनदर ट्रेडिशन डेवलप्ड एट द कोर्ट ऑफ द किंग्स कॉल्ड नर्तला. नर्तला स्टाइल में यही देवदासी होती थी, उनको कोर्ट में अपॉइंट कर दिया जाता. और कुछ लड़कों को जब ट्रेंड किया गया डांस करने, उसको बोला गया गोतीपुआ, GOTIPUA, गोतीपुआ. सो वी हैव थ्री फॉर्म्स ऑफ ओडिशा डांस फॉर्म, ओडिशी डांस फॉर्म. सो राइट देयर फॉर्म्स ऑफ ओडिशी डांस फॉर्म और सब फॉर्म्स. First one, which is called Mehri. Second one, Nartala. And third one, Gotipua. Mehri, so for centuries, Mehris were the chief repositories of this dance. So they tended to preserve this dance form with extreme purity. इन्होंने अच्छे से प्रिजर्व करके रखा मंदिरों में this dance. They were Mehris, they were originally temple dancers. While Nartala, when this style, this sub style emerged, when temple dancers were employed at the royal court, which led to degeneration. Which led to degeneration of this art form started. So from there and onwards, this dance form started degenerating, degrading. गड़बड़ होने लगा यहां से. तो फिर गोतीपुआ को ट्रेन किया गया. गोतीपुआ मींस अ क्लास ऑफ बॉयज वर ट्रेन्ड इन द आर्ट एंड दे डांस्ड इन द टेंपल्स एंड also for general entertainment. Okay, na? So like other classical dance forms like Bharatanatyam. So actually Odissi dance form is closely as it resembles like Bharatanatyam. Dono ke steps milte julte lagte hain kyunki dono hi Bharat Muni ke natya shastra ko ekdam closely follow karte hain. Okay, so right here highly stylized, highly stylized dance form based on Natya Shastra of Bharat Muni and देखिए दोनों एक ही किताब में, दोनों किताबें ना वहां पे भी थी ना, नाट्य शास्त्र ऑफ भरत मुनि एंड अभिनय दर्पण ऑफ नंदीकेश्वरा. हालांकि कुछ और टेक्स्ट बुक में लेकिन इतना रहने देते हैं ना. एंड ऑफ कोर्स एंड 12th सेंचुरी गीत, ये तो लिख ही डालते हैं, गीत गोविंद ऑफ जयदेव. All the ten incarnations. This Sujata Mahapatra, so great dancer. ये क्या आने लगा फिर Netflix? ठीक ना? So female steps predominates here. In ये ज़्यादा feminine है. Lyrical, feminine, soft. And technical details centered around two body posture. See, body posture imitating square. Body posture imitating square is called chowk. C-H-O-W-K, chowk. And chowk to ye ho jayega masculine body position while imitating square is masculine state. Then movement of नेक गर्दन, देखते ना कुछ कुछ डांसर्स ऐसे ऐसे पूरा गर्दन दाएं बाएं हो जाता है. नेक, हाँ वैसे नेक टॉर्सो, टॉर्सो दिस पार्ट, नेक टॉर्सो एंड नीज कॉल्ड त्रिभंगा. वो ज्यादा मूवमेंट होगा तो वो फीमेल स्टेप हो जाएगा, फेमिनिन. सो मैस्कुलिन एंड फेमिनिन कॉल्ड चौक एंड त्रिभंगा, थ्री बॉडी पार्ट्स. Next reading, technical details. So, built around two basic posture. So, techniques of the movement are built around two basic postures. First posture is called chalk, and another posture is called tribhanga. So, chalk means body position imitating a square. Body position imitating a square, a very masculine posture with weight of body is equally distributed. Body position imitating a square, a very masculine posture with weight of body is equally distributed. While tribhanga means it includes movement of neck, torso and knees, and this being very feminine, hana. So while very feminine, which means deflection, and it includes deflection of neck, torso and knees, and avoidance of hip and shoulder movement. So very feminine, deflection of neck, torso and knees, but no deflection of hip or shoulder movement. ठीक है, देखिए, नी मूवमेंट बहुत है, नेक टॉर्सो एंड नी मूवमेंट, वेल अवॉइडेंस ऑफ शोल्डर एंड हिप. ये ओपनिंग आइटम है मंगलाचरण, इसको यहां पे मंगलाचरण बोलते हैं, है ना, इन्वोकेशन ऑफ द डीआईटी. तो यहां पे डीआईटी कौन होंगे? जगन्नाथ, लॉर्ड ऑफ द यूनिवर्स, जगन्नाथ के साथ बलराम और सिस्टर सुभद्रा. देखिए ना, बॉडी पोजीशन इमिटेटिंग स्क्वायर. चलिए स्टेजेस. Stages, first one,
While opening item is called Mangalacharan. ठीक है ना, followed by invocation of the deity, and third aspect is very important, it's called Batu or Nrita, which means pure dance. Batu or Nrita, so pure dance, and it includes duality of masculine and feminine through basic stances of chalk and tribhanga. So pure dance or batu is followed by abhinay or dramatic element. So next fourth stage is called abhinay, which means dramatic, including dramatic element. And fifth one, end, end through a medium of dance called moksha dance. Moksha means end. ठीक है, देन कितने हो गए, चार ही हुए, फोर. फिफ्थ वन, बस यही चार बड़े बड़े थे, ज्यादा टेक्निकल, बाकी थोड़ा थोड़ा. सत्रिय, इट्स नॉट क्षत्रिय, सत्र. सत्र मीन्स वैष्णव मठ. सो फ्रॉम असम, ओरिजिनेटेड ड्यूरिंग द 15th सेंचुरी कॉमन इरा. एंड सत्रिय डांस फॉर्म इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड इन द लिस्ट ऑफ क्लासिकल डांस फॉर्म, डांस फॉर्म. And it was introduced by Vaishnav Saint of 15th century Assam named Sankardev. While it was nurtured and preserved with great commitment by the satras or Vaishnav Math. And it is influenced by local folk dances of northeastern region, influenced by local folk dances of Assam and adjacent areas. So satras, and then it, next one, Manipuri, another classical dance form from northeastern region. Hai na? Satri and Manipuri. So Manipuri from classical dance form of Manipur. तो एक तो केरला हो गया, जहां से दो है, और नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन से केरला से दो है, कथकली एंड मोहिनी यट्टम. लिखिए मणिपुरी में, लिखिएगा This dance is associated with Manipuri dance is associated with rituals and traditional festivals. Rituals and traditional festivals. Second point, associated with dances of Shiva and Parvati. Dances of Shiva and Parvati and other gods and goddesses. And other gods and goddesses who are associated with creation of the universe. Third point, Lai Haroba is the earliest form of dance. Lai Haroba is the earliest form of dance. This dance, Manipuri dance, which forms the basics of all stylized dances of Manipur. Which forms the basics of all stylized dances of Manipur. Literal meaning of Lai Haroba is merrymaking of the gods. Bhagwan ko prasanna karna. Merrymaking of the gods. Next point, Kiga. The principal performers are the Maibas and Maibis. Maibas and Maibis. Which means priests and priestesses. In bracket, priests and priestesses. Right, last point. Congregational singing, ye abhi prelims mein aaya tha. Congregational singing accompanied by the dance. Congregational singing accompanied by the dance, which is known as Sankirtan, S-A-M, which is known as Sankirtan. While male dancers play the pung musical instrument. Pung. Abhi ek movie mein kya us kaun sa gana aaya tha, Salman Khan ki movie thi, usme gaane mein bolta hai pyar ki pungi baja ke. तो पुंगी नहीं है वो, पुंग इज एक्चुअली पुंग, म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट पुंग, एंड करतल 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 मतलब ताली बजाना, हाथ से आवाज करना। एक और लिखिए, दो अभी बचा हुआ है, नेक्स्ट वन, बस दो दो चार चार लाइन लिखेंगे ज्यादा नहीं। कुचिपुड़ी क्लासिकल डांस फॉर्म ऑफ यस एपी आंध्र प्रदेश विच इज डिराइव फ्रॉम यक्षगान एंड इट वॉज रिवाइव्ड बाय सिद्धेंद्र योगी ड्यूरिंग द 17th सेंचुरी व्हाइल इट इज सेंटर्ड अराउंड सेंटर्ड अराउंड राधा कृष्णा कल्ट। फाइल फुटवर्क कंट्रोल एंड बैलेंस ऑफ बॉडी एंड एक्रोबेटिक डांसिंग, ये इसमें देख तो सर पे तीन तीन चार चार घड़ा रख के डांस कर लेते हैं ये लोग, पानी भरा हुआ घड़े, एक्रोबेटिक, इट्स लाइक एक्रोबेटिक डांस फॉर्म। एंड म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स इंक्लूडिंग वायलिन फ्लूट एंड तंबूरा। एक रह गया, बस लास्ट में लिखिएगा मोहिनी यट्टम। मोहिनी मीन्स ब्यूटीफुल लेडी। केरला सो वेल मोहिनी यट्टम इज एसेंशियली अ सोलो डांस एंड परफॉर्म बाय फीमेल डांसर बट नाउअडेज ऑल्सो परफॉर्म्ड इन ग्रुप्स। And originated as a love and devotion towards Krishna and Vishnu. Well, next point will be a feminine steps. Predominates accompanied by Carnatic music and dancer wears either white or Thank you.
off-white costumes. And great exponents, including Gayatri Govind, Lilamma, Sunanda Nair, Satyabhama, Smita Rajan, and many others. Ho gaya na? Dance forms. Chaliye, rehne dete hain itna. Break lete hain, fir discussion karenge, test or discussion. एक मिनट, बोलिए. होमवर्क लिखिए कल के लिए, और एकदम पढ़ के आइएगा. बिना पढ़े तो आइएगा ही मत. मैं बताता हूं, एक टेक्स्ट बुक, बिपिन चंद्रा, इंडिया स्ट्रगल फॉर इंडिपेंडेंस. मैं चैप्टर नंबर बोल रहा हूं. India's struggle for independence. Chapter number 5, fifth chapter. Foundation of Indian National Congress, the reality. Foundation of INC, the reality. Chapter number 7. And an economic critic too of colonialism. Chapter number 8, fight to secure press freedom. चैप्टर नंबर 10, जितना पढ़ पाएगा उतना ही पढ़ेगा. ना मैं लिख रहा हूं बस. दी वैसे तीन चार चैप्टर तो हो जाएगा. द स्वदेशी मूवमेंट, द स्वदेशी मूवमेंट. सो कल इतना तो पढ़ के आएगा एटलीस्ट. थोड़ा रहेगा ना म्यूजिक, वो कल एक घंटे में कराता हूँ. Foundation of INC, the reality, and economic critique, at least these two chapters. And if possible, cover up all the four chapters. And essential. Pahla, fifth and seventh, bahut important hai. Agli chaar dino mein aapko kam se kam 15 chapter khatam karna hai Bipin Chandra ka. Bipin Chandra, I'm talking about Bipin Chandra, India's struggle for independence, and not any guidebook. Not any guidebook. Proper textbook. Not a spectrum. Not talking about a spectrum or any other guidebook. Proper textbook. Just go through proper textbook, otherwise you are not going to solve any question related to freedom of struggle. Guidebooks are merely for revising your content. And Spectrum guidebook is nothing but copy of Bipin Chandra's India's struggle for independence. Okay, na? So last time when my student, she secured fourth rank, सौम्या पांडे, उसने पूरा, मैंने जैसा जैसा सजेस्ट किया था सब कुछ उसने पढ़ा था. सो जस्ट फॉलो ऑल द इंस्ट्रक्शंस, सो वर्क हार्ड एंड यू आर गोइंग टू गेट एनी रैंक इन दिस एग्जामिनेशन. इन टॉप 20, टॉप 50, मेरा पढ़ाया हुआ स्टूडेंट अब तक टॉप 5 में दो हैं. सेकंड रैंक सुप्रीत सिंह गुलाटी IITM, एंड फोर्थ रैंकर सौम्या पांडे. फर्स्ट रैंक मेरे पास अभी तक नहीं है, खाली है. देखिए कौन लगाता है आप में से. पता नहीं होता किसी को भी किसका रैंक आता है किसका नहीं आता. ठीक है, बस आप पढ़ते रहिएगा. चलिए ठीक है.